Hello, and welcome to a short orientation of my math lab. Once you are registered in my math lab, you want to run the browser check, install the Pearson Lockdown browser, which you will need to take any test or quiz, and then take the How to Enter Answers tour. Then you're ready to get down to studying. I suggest that Saturday through Thursday, you do your reading, watching videos, and homework, and then at the latest, Friday morning, but preferably Thursday, take your weekly test or quiz. That way, if there's a problem, I can help you out. Now let's go back to our menu. Up towards the top, you will find a weekly checklist of things that are due that week. Let's go through some of these folders here. You will find the whole book online under chapter contents. Then you will find the videos in the multimedia library. You can search for those by section or by chapter or by type. As you're watching the videos, you want to fill out the video organizer files. Those are guided lecture notes. I'll bring one up so you can see them. And they've got blanks that you should fill out as you're watching the videos. In Math 15, these folders are named slightly differently. The multimedia library is still there, but you can also get to it through a folder called Author in Action Videos, and the video organizer is called the Guided Lecture Notes. Okay, after you've watched videos and read your book and filled out your lecture notes, you probably want to start on your homework. You'll find homework and quizzes and tests all in the Assignments tab. I've only got one up here, but I want to show you how that works. I'm going to click on this homework. As you can see, I've already started this homework, and my current score is 5.38%. So I've got some room for improvement here. Let's go to a question that I previously got wrong. As long as it's before Friday night at midnight, you can open up this homework repeatedly and work on it again and again until your score is 100. So here's a problem I got wrong. And if I click on similar question, I can have three more tries to get it right. So let's get it wrong again. Put W in. Check answer. Sorry. Now let's get it right. -3 to the 4th power is positive 81. So I'm going to enter that, check my answer. Good job, it says. And it marked that incorrect problem. If you go to the overview here, now you can see question 10 is correct and my score has increased. For each problem, I can do that up to three times. I can click on similar question up to three times and I get three chances to answer each question. So essentially you get 9 tries per question. Click on save, and you can come back and work on that later. After the due date, you cannot access these homework problems to redo them, but you can if you go to the study plan. So the study plan has the exact same problems as the homework. You need to search for them yourself by chapter and section, but you can practice the same homework problems all day long from the study plan, and it will not affect your grade in any way. Another thing I wanted to mention about homework is under question help, you'll see something called Help Me Solve This, and it will take you through a very detailed description of how to solve the problem. But I want to warn you not to use that too often because it will rot your brain. Think of that as like a dessert. You want to use it every once in a while when you're incredibly stuck. But if you can't solve a problem, you should go back to your book and you should be reading and watching videos, and you should try and avoid using this too much. Also up here is something called Ask My Instructor. If you use that, it will send me a link to the problem, and you can write a short description of where you're having trouble. I am going to ask you to show me what you've done, and if you need to send me your work, you can take a picture of it, or you can use an editor in Microsoft Word and send me that work as a separate email. Okay, and so also from the assignments folder, that's where you take your tests or quizzes. I have none up right now. Gradebook is self-explanatory. Discussion board is self-explanatory. That's where the discussion board is. The documents folder is where you will find a copy of the syllabus, some options for tutoring, midterm and final information that everyone should read, and some information on how to do better on tests if you're doing really well on homework but not so well on the tests. And finally, one more tab I want to mention is the external videos folder. Here I have links to Khan Academy videos and to some of my own videos. But you should play around with this menu. You can't break anything, so just click on everything and check it out and make sure you're not missing anything before you get started in the course.